broadcast. Let's go to Waycross Georgia Self-Rule Ministry live this morning once again. And tonight it's recorded. I'm Warren Lee.
WHLJ 97.5 FM, 1400 AM and 103.3 Statenville, Valdosta, Moultrie, Georgia.
Victorious Living Bible Institute Incorporated, an affiliate of Christian Bible Institute and Seminary, a non-denominational Bible institute founded as part of the Christian Education Department of the Upper Room Outreach Ministries Incorporated, based in Waycross, Georgia. VLBI has expanded now with an on-site campus in Kenya. Our mission is to equip men and women of God to be productive and functioning parts of the local body of Christ. VLBI provides affordable biblical education and leadership training for ministers, professionals, and laypersons. We will provide you with the skills, education, and character needed to effectively serve, equip, and shape the lives of others as they pursue excellence in Christian education, ministry, and leadership. Study on site at our Waycross campus or online in our Learning Center. Visit www.victoriouslbi.org. Call 1-833-884-8880.
Command your morning with Evangelist Renee Sellers on the prayer line, Monday through Friday, beginning at 5 a.m. to 6 a.m. and 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. Monday through Friday, with devotion, prayer, and pronouncement of daily affirmations. Set the atmosphere for your day. Say what you want to see. Dial 1-712-770-4010. Using access code 266-590. That's 1-712-770-4010. Using access code 266-590. Set the atmosphere for your day. Say what you want to see on the prayer line with Evangelist Renee Sellers.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning. Good morning on this motivational Monday morning. This is Evangelist Renee Sellers of the Upper Room Outreach Ministries in Waycross, Georgia, and we are live at 5 on this Monday morning, getting started again as we prepare to get in. This is November 18th, 2019, and we're excited today to be coming to you live on WHLJ 97.5 FM, 103.3 FM, 1400 AM, Statenville, Valdosta, Moultrie, Georgia. You can join us online this morning at Foxy, FOXY97.com. And you can join us on the call, the conference call with these awesome men and women of God at 712-770-4010, access code 266-590. There will be a recap tonight at 7 p.m. on WHLJ. I want to call this Living the Victorious Life. This is where we are on Wednesdays in Bible study. We're doing a series now. Living the victorious life. We talk about victory. Victorious is the victorious living is what Holy Spirit gave to me years ago, and it's part of our school's name, and it's part of our women's empowerment, and it's just part of a book that I've been working on and should have finished last year. But we're excited because we need to understand what it means to live a victorious life. We often quote from 1 John chapter 5, verses 4 and 5. And I like the new Living Translation of this verse. 1 John chapter 5, verses 4 and 5 of the New Living Translation. It says, "For every child of God defeats this evil world, and we achieve this victory through our faith. And who can win this battle against the world? Only those who believe that Jesus is the Son of God." I like that because it includes the words victory. And those who believe that Jesus is the Son of God, those are the ones who win the battle against the world. So today we begin talking about a battle for your body. Mm-hmm. We're going to discuss this is a series, a battle for your body. How many of you know that the enemy is after your physical well-being? So we're going to get into prayer. We already know he wants our mind. You know, we already know that he influences our thinking. But when he influences our thinking, many times it affects us physically. So we're going to talk about the battle for your body. I don't know how long this series is going to take, but prepare to take notes. Prepare to go back and study them in your private time. But we're going to dig into the Word of God as we talk about the battle for your body. Our topic for today is kingdoms in conflict. I'm going to ask Evangelist Paulette Griffin, if she can, to open our broadcast with a word of prayer.
Heavenly Father, we give you glory, praise, and honor. We thank you for this day. We thank you for another opportunity, Lord God, to be able to come before thy throne room of grace. Thanking you right now, Lord God, for the sweet kiss of thy precious Holy Spirit that has awakened us this day, Lord God, to receive thy word that it may be planted upon good ground, to come up into fruition as you called it to be. We thank you for moving us, Jehovah Elohim, the Lord God, our creator, for creating us in your own image and making us a living nephesh to be able to glorify and praise thy holy name. Lord God, we thank you for moving us, Jehovah Shalom, the Lord God, our peace, the bringer of peace that surpasses all understanding, even in the midst of the battle and the storm, Lord God. Heavenly Father, we thank you and we praise you right now, Lord God, for all that you've done in our lives and what you're yet to do, Lord God, as you move us, Jehovah Jireh, the Lord God, our provider, for providing and meeting the needs in our lives, both naturally and spiritually, as you honor the covenant that you made with our forefathers. You, Lord God, we thank you and we praise you, Lord God, for this time of opportunity. We thank you for the Upper Room Outreach Ministries, Pastor Samuel, Evangelist Renee Sellers, for bringing forth Command Your Morning Prayer Line, that we can come together from the north, the south, the east, and the west, together in your name, learning more about thee, Lord God. Heavenly Father, Lord God, let thy word take fruition right now, Lord God, and Heavenly Father, be planted upon good ground to come up in fruition as you called it to be. We love you, we thank you, and we praise you for this day and all that you've done and what you're yet to do. In the matchless name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen.
Amen. Thank you so much, woman of God. I've wanted to share this for quite some time, but it was not the timing. The Holy Spirit was giving me other things, so I believe this is the time because I'm at peace with what I'm sharing today. But we're talking about kingdoms in conflict as we talk about a battle for your body. There are so many people that are dealing with sickness, and I thank God for last week's series as we talked about salvation, and we did the 3 days on how to on salvation and those 13 steps to growing in God. I mean, that was just, I'm still in awe at God for those 12 steps, not 13, 12. 12 steps to growing in God. But we're talking today because there's so much sickness, even in the body. There's so many people that are dealing with issues, cancer, diabetes. I wish my brother was on the call. I'm going to send him this recording. Diabetes and all these different things affect our body. So we're going to talk about spiritual warfare, and we did a series on spiritual warfare. We've done it on the call and on at our ministry, and for some reason, when you begin to talk about the things that the enemy tries to do, it's like people don't want to really hear it. People start falling off. They stop showing up. We want to live a victorious life, but we don't want to understand how to win this spiritual battle. Winning the spiritual battle is part of that victorious life, but we got to recognize what's really happening. And so we're going to identify the reason for this. There is an invisible war going on, and we're going to identify the reason for this war. We're going to define divine healing during this series. We're going to identify the source of sickness. Somebody might want to stay with us. We're going to identify the source of sickness. We're going to explain the reasons for sickness. We're going to talk about the types of sickness. We're going to list the end results of sickness. And we're going to look at some biblical scriptures that relate to our healing. And so as we go through this, we're going to give a scripture that gives us what we need, what I want to call a healing promise to claim. We're going to give a scripture, a healing. I pray that we have time to wrap up. If I quit talking and get on into the devotion, I think I can finish today. But we're going to give you every time, as often as we can, rather, a healing promise to claim. Your healing promise for today is coming from Exodus chapter 15, verse 26. Hallelujah. Exodus chapter 15 and verse 26. I like to read, I love the King James, it's the authorized version, but I'm going to read this from New King James this morning, Exodus 15. If you have anybody in your family or if that's you that is dealing with issues in your body, this is the series for you. Exodus 15. Did I just pop my – I mean, Exodus 15 and 26. And it says, and if you diligently heed the voice of the Lord your God and do what is right in his sight, give ear to his commandments and keep all his statutes, I will put none of the diseases on you which I have brought on the Egyptians, for I am the Lord who heals you. Now, if you don't remember anything else about that scripture, remember the last part which says, for I am the Lord who heals you. I need somebody to claim that promise that I serve a God who heals me. And so we need to understand that there is a war, there is a battle going on in the world today. And it's not between nations, it's not between tribes, it's not between the Democrats and the Republicans, it's not between Donald Trump and the Senate or the House, whatever's going on. It's not a coup. It is an invisible battle, and it's taking place in the spirit world. Somebody might want to write this down. And we're going to introduce this invisible war as we talk about this today, that every believer is engaged in some type of warfare. We might not want to acknowledge it. As a matter of fact, we might not even recognize what's really happening. But you and I are engaged in warfare, whether it's with your family, and we're fighting our husbands and wives, not even realizing that there's sometimes, even at home, you're dealing with spiritual. Listen, this is a spiritual battle, and now you're using the word divorce and not realizing that this is an agenda against the enemy to come against you and your spouse. Listen, we got issues with our children sometimes, and we get mad at our children, not realizing. And ladies and gentlemen, that this is a spiritual battle. And the same way that the enemy comes against your family, he comes against your physical body. This is a war where we don't wear a uniform, but everybody is a target. And so this historical and prophetical record of this war is found in the Word of God. There are some things that I have some young people that they have some questions that they want me to answer. And I believe if they join us on the call, and or maybe I can go live sometimes, you know, at 5 a.m. is kind of early for me to go live. But we're thankful today that the young people, we say they don't want to have anything to do with God, but I'm finding out that they really do. There's just a lot that they don't understand. And so to understand this invisible war, you and I have to understand the natural and spiritual wars. Man exists in two worlds. If you were in Bible study upper room, you understand what those two worlds are. Somebody write down the natural world and the spiritual world. The natural world is what I'm looking at, my computer, my office, my laptop, my iPad, my phone. These are these things that I can see and feel and touch. And these things are visible in the natural senses. It is tangible. You can touch it and you can see it. This is the natural world. The country and the nation and the city, the streets that we live on, all this is part of the natural world. That steak that you ate for dinner last night in that restaurant, that is part of the natural world. You and I are a resident in a natural kingdom located on one of the continents in this world. You and I can see the people that are part of our environment. We can communicate with them. We can experience sights and sounds and smells all around us. But we have to understand, ladies and gentlemen, that there is another world in which we live. And this is the spirit, what we call the spirit realm, the spirit world. You cannot see it with your physical eyes, but it's just as real as the voice that you're hearing on this broadcast this morning. We can't see it with our physical eyes, Dr. Harris, but it's just as real as that nice truck that you be driving and taking people around all the time. Listen, it's just as real as the phone that you're holding up to your ear or the radio that you're listening to right now. You cannot see it with your physical eyes, but this world is real. In 1 Corinthians 15 and verse 40, the Apostle Paul talks about the division of natural and spiritual. Paul says that there is a natural or terrestrial body, and there is a spiritual or celestial body. Let me say that again. A natural or terrestrial body. And then there is a spiritual or celestial body. And so all of us have a natural body that we live in this natural world. But you and I, man, is also a spiritual being, and we have a soul and a spirit. We have an eternal soul. We have an eternal spirit. We are three-part beings. Somebody say body, soul, and spirit, three-part beings. And so our spiritual being, that soul and spirit, is part of a spiritual world, just as our natural body is part of the natural world. If you didn't get it just now, tune in tonight at 7 p.m. And so because there is spiritual warfare, because the spiritual warfare is just that, it is spiritual, it is spiritual. And that's where you got to be able to recognize what's really happening. What was going on with Adam and Eve in Genesis chapter 3 was a spiritual battle. One of the reasons is because I believe had Eve and Adam recognized what was really happening, they never would have given ear to the enemy. They never would have given ear to the serpent. They would not, did not recognize that there was an invisible war going on even in Genesis chapter 3. Mm-hmm. There was an invisible war. And so in our natural sinful state, we cannot understand spiritual things. And that's why I'm so thankful for last week's devotion, because now we're born again. Now we're children of God. Now we got all that. We're making Jesus Lord of our life. Now we can begin to understand spiritual things. And one of the reasons that some of these young people have so many questions is because they're giving their ear to so many different voices. Watch this. Oh, God, they're giving their ear to so many different voices. I am so thankful. And this really blessed me, because there are some things that I was planning on doing with Command Your Morning, but I was looking at what I was able to do. But I have to realize that if God called you to it, he'll enable you to do it. But I received a letter from someone who is incarcerated in a local facility that has a life sentence, and I'm sure without revealing their name, they said they're incarcerated and have a life sentence for murder. And this thing right here, really, one of the things that really stood out for me, he said, "We prisoners are a group of people easily forgotten." He said, "Your radio broadcast literally saved my life." He says, "I'm ready to live as hard for God as I did for the Bloods." Now, with everything that our young people are listening to, even in prison, in college, in all other the armed forces and all kind of other things, we are thankful today that somebody is giving their ear to this broadcast. But if this broadcast had not been available, we don't know where this young man might be right now. He can be free even behind bars. Can I get somebody to shout amen? Because you got to be free mentally if you're going to be free physically. And my brother, Pastor Jamie Therese, wrote a book, and he talked about going from dope to hope. He was incarcerated and was sentenced to 24 years in federal prison. And while in prison, there was a man that was always happy. He was always had joy. He had the peace that Jamie said he didn't understand. This man that had so much joy and peace was also serving 24 years in federal prison. But he was happy. He was happy. Because he realized that even though naturally I'm in prison, I'm behind bars, that spiritually I can experience the joy of the Lord. And so 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 14. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 14. I'm going to be reading from the New King James Version of the Bible. 1 Corinthians 2, 14. It says, "But the natural man does not receive the things of the Spirit of God, for they are foolishness to him, nor can he know them because they are spiritually discerned. They are foolishness to him, nor can he know them because they are spiritually discerned. Anyone who does not have God's spirit thinks the things of God and the blessings of God are foolish. This is why they can't accept the fact that you live in a nice house, because they don't understand that as being a child of God, the blessings of God go along with being his child. And so it's necessary for us, listen, to use spiritual discernment to understand spiritual things. Got to be able to discern. And I often tell people, if you don't have any other gift of the Holy Spirit, you need the discerning of spirits. You need to be able to discern what's God and what's not when you and your spouse have a disagreement. You need to be able to discern what's God and what's not when you go to work and your boss talks to you and you did nothing wrong. You need to be able to discern what's God and what's not when you're dealing with issues in your body and in your family that you don't understand. And one of the best examples of natural and spiritual discernment is recorded in 2 Kings chapter 6. In this story of a natural battle where troops of the enemy nation of Syria had surrounded a small town called Dothan where the prophet Elisha was staying. When Elisha's servant Gehazi saw the great host of the enemy, the Bible says he became fearful. Elisha prayed that God would open his eyes. I ministered this. The Lord opened my eyes some time ago. Elisha prayed that God would open his servant's eyes, his spiritual eyes. Watch this. So that he could see the angelic host that was surrounding and protecting them. Ladies and gentlemen, somebody needs to say, Lord, open my spiritual eyes today so that I can see that I'm not in this battle by myself. And so in this particular occasion, God actually opened the natural eyes of Gehazi and allowed him to visibly see the forces of God aligning for battle. And so in this story in 2 Kings chapter 6, you can read it at your leisure time, in this battle at Dothan is similar to what we go through in the church. This story at Dothan in 2 Kings chapter 6 is similar to present spiritual conditions in the church, because there are some like Elisha who see clearly in the realm of the spirit. They know there is a conflict occurring, and they have identified the real enemy and recognized the forces of God that can assure that we have the victory in this battle. But there are others, watch this, like Gehazi, who with little encouragement will be able to open their spiritual eyes, and they'll no longer be fearful. They'll no longer live a defeated life. They'll no longer let the enemy, listen, influence their behavior. They'll no longer allow these things to go on even in their body if they won't allow those things to stop them from getting what they need from God. There are many people who, like those in the city of Dothan, are spiritually sleeping. How many of you, oh God, there are many today that are spiritually sleeping. Today, on this Motivational Monday, I encourage you to come up out of your sleep. Those that are spiritually sleeping don't even know that the enemy has surrounded them and is ready for the attack. And this is why our intercessors need to be alert, why our prayer warriors need to stay alert. This is why we need to be alert so that we can recognize what's going on around us. There's an enemy that's seeking to attack, and you don't recognize it because you're spiritually asleep. You're spiritually asleep. And many times we as parents, we've got to be awake spiritually. We got to be alert spiritually so that we can discern and God can speak to us concerning things that is relative to our children. Or one of my daughters was dealing with some issues, and we were on the phone, just she and, you know, we talk on the phone, and, you know, with your daughters, I thank God for my daughters. You know, we can kind of just laugh and talk. My girls are some of the funniest people I know. But in a casual conversation on the phone, Holy Spirit shared with me, and I shared this with my daughter because she was applied for this job and was concerned about the job. Holy Spirit said, watch this. Holy Spirit said, let me tell her that, listen, the Lord said, you got the job, but there's going to be some issues with transportation. About a week later, something happened with her car. And she called me and said, Mama, you said this. But then God had something greater for her because that car, listen, wasn't useful for her anymore. God had a new vehicle waiting on her and a new job. I need somebody to say we have to be able to discern the things of God and be able to recognize and discern what's God and what's not. So with the natural and spiritual realms of which we're speaking, there exist separate kingdoms, which are ruled by natural and spiritual leaders. I got to finish. I have 4 minutes to wrap this up. Natural and spiritual leaders. Somebody say two kingdoms, two spiritual kingdoms. Let's talk about this natural kingdom real quick. All of us, you and I, live in a natural kingdom. We live in a city, Valdosta, Waycross, Homerville, Miami, Statesboro, Las Vegas, Lake City, Ray City. We live in different cities or villages, Kitale, Kenya, Eldoret, Nairobi, part of a nation. That nation is a kingdom of the world. A natural kingdom is a territory or people over which an actual king or political leader is the sovereign ruler. The Bible speaks of these natural kingdoms as the kingdoms of the world. The kingdoms of the world have come under the power and influence of Satan. Matthew chapter 4, verses 8 and 9. The kingdoms of the world, the cities. This is why we need believers in positions of government. This is why we need more believers to step out of the box and begin to go out and do things to help shift your community. Matthew chapter 4, verses 8 and 9, it says, again, the devil took him up, Jesus, on an exceedingly high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world and their glory. And he said to him, all these things I will give you if you will fall down and worship me. John 5 and 19 reminds us that the whole world, John 5, 19, is under the control of the evil one. It's natural kingdoms under the control of the evil one. How did he get that control? Back in Genesis chapter 3. Adam relinquished that control to Satan in the garden. And so these spiritual kingdoms, in contrast to the natural kingdoms, in addition to these natural kingdoms of this world, there are two spiritual kingdoms, the kingdom of Satan and the kingdom of God. Every person alive, watch this, is a resident of one of these two kingdoms. We talked about this in our spiritual warfare series, that every person alive, you and me, are a resident of one of these two kingdoms, the kingdom of Satan or the kingdom of God. My question for you on this Motivational Monday morning, of which kingdom are you a resident? Of which kingdom are you a resident? Mr. Lee, is this too deep for Monday morning? Is this too deep for Command Your Morning today? Which kingdom are you a resident? So the kingdom of Satan, what does it consist of? You'll find out which kingdom you're a resident of in about a minute. The kingdom of Satan consists of Satan, spiritual beings called demons. Watch this. And all men who live in sin and rebellion to God's word. Plus the world and the flesh are the spiritual forces of evil at work in the world today. Are we a participator in the kingdom of Satan? Are we residents of the kingdom of Satan? Or are we residents of the kingdom of God? Let me explain the kingdom of God first. The kingdom of God consists of God, our Father, Jesus Christ, Holy Spirit, angels, spiritual beings called angels, and all of us who live in righteous obedience to God's word. These are the spiritual forces of good. Let me say something about the kingdom of Satan and the kingdom of God. All of us were at one time residents of the kingdom of Satan. There are so many today that are still living under his rule. When something is a part of a kingdom, that means we're under their rule and authority. Mm-hmm. were under their rule and authority. So the kingdom of God, watch this, is not a denomination. If we're part of a denomination and that's something that you a part of, that's certainly something that's your conviction. Denominations are man-made organizations of groups of churches. There's nothing wrong with that. Listen, you're preaching Jesus. As long as Jesus is preached, hey, they have been established for practical purposes of organization and administration. So there's nothing wrong with denominations. Denominations are major church organizations like Baptist, Assembly of God, Methodist, Lutheran, etc. But the Bible speaks of the true church, which is not a denomination or religious organization. The true church is composed of all those who have become residents through salvation, through repentance, through putting personal faith in Jesus Christ, as we talked about last week, by making Jesus Lord and Savior of their life. The true church is composed of all those who have become residents of the kingdom of God. Watch this now. Even if you're part of a denomination, as long as you're a part of the kingdom of God, have received Jesus as Savior and Lord, you can declare, I am a resident of the kingdom of God. At the present time in the natural, but we want to understand that the true church is about those who are the children of God. Believers, born again, blood bought, believers in Jesus Christ. And so all the present, at this particular time in this world, the natural world, the kingdom of God exists individually within every man, every woman, every boy and girl. It exists within us, those of us who made a decision to follow Jesus Christ, those of us who made a decision to make, listen, to declare Jesus is King. For those of us who made a decision to make Jesus Lord of our life, it exists communally in the true church. And wherever people make this world the kind of world God wants it to be, my question for you today, are you an influencer for the kingdom of God? Are we influencing others around us to become a part of that kingdom and to come out of the kingdom of Satan, where Satan is Lord and where he rules, to become a part of the kingdom of God, where God rules and where Jesus is the head of the church, the body of Christ? And so as we have understanding this, the difference between these two kingdoms, these spiritual kingdoms, now we can move forward and talk about this invisible war. But we won't talk about it today because we're out of time. Let's take a quick break for station ID. We're live at 5 on WHLJ, 97.5 FM, 103.3 FM, 1400 AM, Statenville, Valdosta, Moultrie, Georgia. Also online this morning at Foxy, F-O-X-Y, 97.com, talking about the battle for your body. We got to understand these two spiritual kingdoms if we're going to understand how the enemy comes against your physical body. We're live at 5, and you can join us on the call at 712-770-4010, access code 266-590. There'll be a recap tonight at 7 p.m. on WHLJ. The true church are those that have made a decision to make Jesus Lord of their life. If that's you, welcome to the body of Christ. And so tomorrow morning, as we continue talking about the battle for your body, understanding what we can do to live a victorious life, we're going to talk about this invisible war. But before we close today, let's go and repeat that healing declaration for today. Let's go ahead and repeat this from Exodus chapter 15, verse 26, your healing promise for today. If thou wilt diligently hearken to the voice of the Lord thy God, and wilt do that which is right in his sight, and will give ear to his commandments, and keep all these statutes, I will put none of these diseases upon thee, which I have brought upon the Egyptians. For I am the Lord that heals thee. I want you to declare all day long that I serve a God who can heal any manner of sickness and disease. Your healing promise to claim today. I am. He says, I am the Lord that heals thee. Somebody needs to declare, I know the Lord that heals me. That's all we have time for today. Let us transition into prayer. We thank God today for Pastor Gloria Moore, Evangelist Darlene Gant. That's all. Yeah. Amen. To God be the glory. Evangelist Darlene Gant, woman of God, take us in with a word of prayer as we talk about the battle for your body. We're claiming our healing today. We're starting today and understanding what you can do to be free from those things that come against your body. Evangelist Gant, take us in with a word of prayer.
Father God, we come before you this morning, Lord. Father, we praise you and we're thankful, Father. We're thankful, Father, for this day, Lord. Father, we thank you, Father, for keeping us all night long, Father, watching over us, letting your angels have charge over us, keeping us in our families safe. Oh, Father, we praise you, Father, for your worthy, Father. We glorify your name, Father, for your worthy of all praise, honor, and glory, Father. You alone are worthy, God, and we say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for all that you do for us, Father. For this day, Father, we lift up our voices to you, Father, to praise you. Oh, Father, we lift up our hands, Father. We are in awe of you, Father, and all of your mighty works, Lord. Heavenly Father, we rejoice, Father. We rejoice, Father, for we understand, Father, that you are Almighty God. Oh, Father, we know, Father, that you can do all things. Oh, Heavenly Father, so we humble ourselves this morning, Father, and we ask you, Lord, to clean our hearts, Father. We ask you, Lord, Father, let there be nothing found in us, Father. Oh, Father, that would make us, Father. Oh, Father, have any evil thoughts, Father. Oh, Father, we pray against every thought that will run across our mind, Father, that is not of you, Lord. Oh, Father, we cast it down right now to the pit of hell from whence it come, Lord. Heavenly Father, we ask you to clean our minds, Father, and clean our hearts, Father, that we can serve you well, Father. Oh, Father, you said in your word, if we draw nigh unto you, you can draw nigh unto us, Lord. Oh, Father, so we are praying today, Father, to be closer to you, Lord. Oh, Heavenly Father, we ask you today, Father, oh, Father, to make us, Father, over again, Father. Touch us again, Father. Touch us again, Father. We know, Father, that when you touch us again, my God, hallelujah. Oh, Father, change will take place, Lord. Oh, Father, we thank you, Father. Oh, Father, for we understand that your word says there's nothing too hard for you, Father. Heavenly Father, you rule the world, my God. Oh, Father, for you made this world and everything that is in it. Oh, Father, your word says the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. Them and they that dwell therein, Father. Heavenly Father, so we bless your name today, Father. We bless you because we understand you're almighty. Hallelujah. You're omnipotent. Oh, my God, we thank you, Lord. Oh, Father, we trust you, Father. Oh, Father, we give you glory today, Father. Oh, Father, we give you glory, hallelujah, and honor, hallelujah. Oh, Father, for you are our creator, hallelujah. We are amazed, Lord. We are amazed at your wonderful work. Oh, Father, we give you praise. Oh, Father, we ask you today, Father, to make provisions, Father, for all of those that are homeless, Father. Oh, Father, for those that are struggling, Father. Oh, Father, with financial pressures all around, Lord. Heavenly Father, we know, Father, that you supply all of our needs according to your riches and glory in Christ Jesus. Heavenly Father, we praise you and we thank you, Father. We praise you and we thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Oh, Father, put it in our hearts and our minds that we can be a help to someone, Father. And we can share our bread, Father. Share our drink, Lord. Oh, Father, we thank you today for the opportunity, Lord. Oh, Father, we know there are many that are suffering, Father. Many are suffering. Many are being mistreated, Lord. Oh, Father, they're being abused. Hallelujah. Oh, Father, we cry out for the babies. Oh, Father, for the little ones, the innocent blood that is being shed, Lord. Heavenly Father, we ask you today to make a way, Oh, Father, make a way for them, Father, to be free from the abusers, Oh, Father, make a way for them, Father, in the name of Jesus, Oh, Heavenly Father, we ask you, Father, hallelujah. Oh, Father, look down upon the abusers, Oh, Father, the soul and the mind, Oh, Father, we ask you, Father, hallelujah. Oh, Father, allow them to hear the truth, my God, Oh, Father, that their souls may be saved, Lord, Oh, Father, we know, Father, you're able, Father, to do all things, Father. Oh, Father, we know there's nothing impossible for you, my God, Oh, Father, we ask you to know every bereaved family this morning, that are hurting, hallelujah. Oh, Father, for they've lost their loved ones, Lord. We cry out, Father, that you will comfort them, Father. We cry out, Father, that you, God, hallelujah, will, hallelujah, touch them, hallelujah, like only you can, Father. You can heal the heart, Oh, Father, we pray today, Father. Oh, Father, we ask you, Lord, Oh, Father, to go into those places, Father, where they don't have religious freedom. For all of those, hallelujah, that want to serve you, Father, but they can't do it openly, Father. We ask your Lord, huh? Oh, Father, to make a way for them, Father. As they go forth to do your will, Father, as they go forth to spread the gospel, huh? As they go forth, Father, my Father, we pray today, Father, protection over them, Lord. We ask you, Lord, to send your angels, Father. Oh, Father, to make ways for them, Father. Oh, Father, make provisions for them, Father. Protect, shield them, Lord, huh? Oh, Father, we give you praise today, Father. Oh, Father, we give you praise, Father, for you deserve it all, my God. Oh, Father, we know that you are just God, huh? Oh, Father, we pray that they will receive justice instead of persecution, Lord. Oh, Father, we ask you, Father, oh, Father, to help us in relationships, Father. Help us, Father, to know how to communicate. Help us, Lord, hallelujah. Oh, Father, that we can forgive, huh? Help us, Lord, to tell someone we're sorry. Help us, Father, to say it's okay. We understand and pray and mean it, my God, huh? Oh, Father, we ask you, Father, for guidance in marriages, huh? Oh, Father, please help couples to have hearts of forgiveness, Lord. Oh, Father, where there are wounds, Father, we ask you, Lord, to heal, huh? Heal, my God, the hurts, Father. Oh, Father, give them understanding, huh? Oh, Father, let them remember the vows that they made, huh, before you, my God, huh? Father, you know better, hallelujah, than we do. Oh, Father, you know, Father, you know us, Father. You know everything about us, Father. You know the numbers of hairs on our head, my God, huh? Oh, Father, so we ask you, Lord, huh, to help us to communicate with each other. Oh, Father, help us to learn how to listen, huh? Help us to learn how to be trustworthy, Lord. Trustworthy with confidence, Father. Oh, Father, learning how to bring everything to you and lay it down at your feet, my God, huh? Oh, Father, we pray, Father. Oh, Father, for all the parents that love their children. We pray, Father, they will give them the right instruction, Father, teaching them right from wrong, huh? Oh, Father, we ask you, Lord, today, Father, oh, Father, give the children divine protection, huh? Oh, Father, protection to cover, huh? Or everywhere they go, Lord, we pray, Father, that you will keep them safe, Father. Keep them safe, Lord, in the streets, Father. Keep them safe, Father, in the traveling to school and from school, Lord. Heavenly Father, we pray against every mindset that would cause a terror in the schools, Lord. We pray against the spirit of murder, my God. Huh? Oh, Father, we pray right now, Father. Oh, Father, that every child's mind shall be stable, huh? Oh, Father, we're praying right now, Father. Oh, Father, for the violence to cease in the name of Jesus, huh? Oh, Heavenly Father, we ask you, Lord. Oh, Father, to send our children home safely, Lord. Oh, Father, we ask you today, Father, remember all of those that are sick. Oh, Father, that are suffering in their bodies, Lord. Oh, Father, we pray, Father, for healings in the mighty name of Jesus, huh? Oh, Father, for your word says that Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, huh? Having become a curse for us, Lord. Oh, Father, let us feel, huh, the power of your presence that can heal us everywhere that we're hurting, Father. Oh, Father, may our bodies be overwhelmed with your amazing power, huh? Your miracle-working anointing to be free from all sickness and disease, my God, huh? Oh, Father, we know that you can do anything but fail, and we're asking you, Father. Oh, Father, remember the unsaved souls, Father. Oh, Father, we ask you in the mighty name of Jesus, huh? Oh, Father, open their hearts and their eyes, my God, huh? Oh, Father, they can receive your truth, Lord, huh? Oh, Father, we pray for the souls, huh? Oh, Father, joining the body of Christ each and every day all around the world, my God, huh? Oh, Father, we thank you, Lord, huh? Oh, Father, we thank you for every soul that is saved, huh? Oh, Father, we pray, Father, that you enable us, Father, to welcome them, huh? Oh, Father, to welcome them and be godly examples before them, Father, representing your kingdom well, my God, huh? Oh, Father, we ask you to bless Dr. Renee Sellers and Pastor Samuel Sellers and all the ministers on the line today, Father. We thank you for Dr. Sellers and Pastor Samuel Sellers for bringing command your morning forth, Lord. We thank you for Mr. Lee and all of his staff. Oh, Father, to make it possible that this broadcast can go out, Father. Oh, Father, we thank you, Father. Heavenly Father, you're the supplier of all needs, Father, for every need to be met. Father, on this line today, every church representative, Father, we ask that you are blessed, Lord. Oh, Father, we ask you to bless Pastor Sellers and Dr. Renee Sellers and all the ministry work that they do, Father. Make way for them, Father. Oh, Father, make a way for them, Father. Bless them in their finances, Father. Bless them, Father, in their health, Father. Energize them, Father. Oh, Father, we pray right now, Father. Oh, Father, they walk in blessings, Father. We pray, Father, that everything they lay their hands to, my God, be blessed, Lord. Oh, Father, we ask you today, Father, to keep them safe, Father. Keep them safe and place godly people in their path. I love them, Lord. Oh, Father, we know, Father. Oh, Father, that you can do it, Father. So we pray, Father, to be obedient to our leaders and to honor them, Lord. We ask you, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, we desire to serve you, Lord. Oh, Father, we desire to serve you in our churches and in our homes and everywhere we go, Father. Our desire is to live holy, Father. Heavenly Father, we ask you today, Father. Oh, Father, to guide us through this day, Father. Oh, Father, guide us, Father, that we show love, Father. Guide us in our conversations, Lord, that we speak what is right, Father. Guide us, Father, in how we think, Lord. Oh, Father, let love, hallelujah. Oh, Father, let love be like a magnet, Father. Oh, Father, that others will feel, hallelujah, your presence, Father. Oh, Father, for you, Father, you live on the inside of us, Father. Oh, Father, we thank you, hallelujah. We praise you for the opportunity, Father, to come together on the prayer line, Lord. Oh, Father, we thank you, we ask you, Lord, hallelujah. Oh, Father, to bless the body of Christ, Father. Oh, Father, bless us, Father, as we continue to walk in unity, Father. Oh, Father, we pray against any spirit of division, Father, that wants to rise up in us, Lord. Oh, Father, no matter what it looks like, Father, we trust you. No matter what it sounds like, Father, we stand, ha. Huh? Oh, Father, we thank you. No matter what it feels like, Lord, ha. Huh? Oh, Father, we still depend and trust in you, Lord. Oh, Father, for you are the author and the finisher of our faith, Father. Heavenly Father, we praise you, we thank you, we glorify you, we magnify your name, Lord. Heavenly Father, we ask you, Father, huh? Oh, Father, fill our churches with your glory, Father. Oh, Father, fill our churches with your glory, Lord, huh? Oh, Father, we thank you right now, Father. Oh, Father, we don't want anything to hinder, Father, the purpose that you have for us to fulfill, my God. We thank you for all that you do for us. We thank you for everything, Father. Oh, Father, we thank you, Father. Hallelujah. For even when times are rough, my God, huh, we still stand and hold on, huh? We still stand and hold on to your word, Father. We still stand by faith and believe, my God. Oh, Father, we won't let go, but we are holding on to you, Father. For you never change, my God. Your love is unending, huh? Your compassion, my God, we thank you for, Father. Oh, Father, we thank you for you are faithful, my God, huh? Oh, Father, you never leave us. You never forsake us, Lord. And we give you glory today, Father. Look down upon this nation, Father, and all nations in the world, Father. We pray for peace, Father. We pray, Father, right now for understanding, Lord. Oh, Father, we pray for those that are in leadership. Oh, Father, position, Father, Heavenly Father, that you, Father, oh, Father, would get the glory, Father. We magnify you, Father, and that no decisions are made that will harm your people, Father. Oh, Father, give us wisdom, Father, to make rightful choices, Father. We pray for our leaders to make right choices, Father. Oh, Father, that concerns us, Lord. And we know that you're concerned about everything that concerns your people, my God. So we thank you today, Father. Oh, Father, we depend on you, Father. We pray for the military forces, oh, Father, to be watched over and kept safe, Father. Give them strategies, Father, on how to fight against our enemies, Lord. Heavenly Father, we pray right now, Father, that revival will come into this nation, Lord, and all across the world. Oh, Father, the souls, hallelujah, will be saved, Father. Oh, Father, for we know, Father, hallelujah, oh, Father, that you can open the eyes, the understanding, Father. Oh, Father, let the scales fall from the eyes of the unbeliever, Father. Oh, Father, let them see and know that you reign, my God, that you're the one true and living God. And we praise you, we glorify you, we thank you, Father, for all of these blessings we ask. In your son, Jesus, precious and holy name, amen, and it is so. And if there's anyone on the line today, you have made a decision that you want to be saved. As I say the salvation prayer, please repeat after me. Father, it's written in your word that if I confess with my mouth that Jesus is Lord, and I believe in my heart that you raised him from the dead, I shall be saved. Therefore, Father, I confess that Jesus is my Lord, and I make him Lord of my life right now today. I believe in my heart that you raised Jesus from the dead, and I renounce my past life as Satan, and I close the door to any of his devices. I thank you for forgiving me of all my sins. Jesus is my Lord, and I am a new creation. All things have passed away. Now all things have become new in Jesus' name. If you repeated that prayer after me, we say, welcome to the body of Christ, because you are a new creation. Welcome, we welcome, we welcome you. We love you, and we're so glad that you made the decision to join us. We suggest that you find a church. We pray that you will find a church where you can learn more of the Word of God, learn His Word, study His Word, build your relationship with Him through prayer and through the studying of His Word, and be a member in the church that will sit under authority and be humble and learn. We thank you once again for joining the body of Christ. And we say once again, welcome, that we love you. And at this time, we release the line back to Dr. Renee Sellers of Command Your Morning.
Thank you so much, Evangelist Darlene Gant. We're so thankful for you all joining us today. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Join us tomorrow morning live at 5 as we continue discussing the battle for your body, living the victorious life. That's it. God bless you. God keep you. This is Evangelist Renee Sellers of the Upper Room Outreach Ministries, Waycross, where our pastor is Pastor Samuel Sellers III, coming to you live on Command Your Morning broadcast with these phenomenal men and women of God. Join us every day, Monday through Friday, live at 5 a.m. God bless you. God keep you. Heaven smile upon you. Those on the call, please remain on the line.